Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create fun glitter-filled text encased in glass and how to quickly replace the text without having to redo the effects. I'll also show you how to easily change its color. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago. This version is more flexible and efficient. I provided this glitter texture so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files below. Before we begin, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Double-click an empty area of the glitter layer, and when this window pops up, name it Glitter. Keep in mind, you can use a different texture if you like. Just make its resolution 150 pixels per inch so your results will look similar to mine. Temporarily hide the layer. We'll make a new layer below it by control-clicking or command-clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with a gradient color. Open your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white thumbnail and click the lower right stop. Click the color box and in the hexadecimal field, type in 3642BD. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Place your cursor a bit above the center of your document and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient tool straight down approximately this much. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using Frankfurter Medium. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make its size approximately 300 points. However, feel free to adjust its size based on the amount of characters in your text and the font you use. I'll make its aliasing sharp and center alignment. We'll make the color white so we can see our text better. To do this, press X on your keyboard to invert your foreground and background colors. Now, white is your foreground color. Click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. To reveal the glitter texture only through the text, we'll make the glitter layer into a clipping mask. To do this, make the glitter layer visible and active and press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Make the text active and click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. This allows us to adjust the effects that we'll be adding to it at any time and also allows us to replace our text if we want without having to redo any of the effects. Double-click your text layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is outer bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 20 pixels, and soften it 1 pixel. Uncheck global light. The angle is 16 degrees, and the altitude is 48 degrees. Open the gloss contour and click the gear icon. If small list isn't checked, click it. Click ring. The highlight mode is normal and the color is white. The opacity is 100%. The shadow mode is difference and click the shadows color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 91 three times. Make the shadow's opacity 40%. Click Contour and open the contour presets. Click Cone Inverted. Then click OK. Shift-click the Glitter Clipping Mask to make it active as well, and make a copy of the two active layers by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click Bevel and Emboss to open it in the Layer Style window. Make the Style Inner Bevel the angle minus 144 degrees and the altitude 51 degrees. Make the shadow's opacity 30%. Shift-click the glitter copy and make a copy of the two active layers. Double-click Bevel and Emboss to open it in the Layer Style window. Make the depth 550%, the size 27 pixels, and soften it 12 pixels. Make the angle 120 degrees and the altitude 40 degrees. Make the gloss contour linear, the highlight mode vivid light, and its opacity 75%. Change the blend mode to multiply and make the color's brightness 35%. Then click OK. Make its opacity 75%. Click Inner Glow. The color is black, the blend mode is pin light, and the opacity is 54%. The choke is 30%, and the size is 20 pixels. Then click OK. We'll convert all the layers that comprise our glitter text into one smart object by making the top clipping mask active and shift-clicking the bottom text to make all these layers active. Open the flyout list and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it and go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Press and hold Shift as you drag the flipped copy straight down until it's close with the top text. If the flipped text is trying to snap to the top text, go to View and click Snap to uncheck it. Reduce the reflection's opacity to 30%. Next, we'll fade out the reflection from the bottom. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the reflection layer. Open your gradient tool and click the gradient bar. Click the black-white thumbnail and click OK. Go to the bottom of the reflection and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient tool straight up to the top of the reflection. Next, I'll show you how to quickly replace your text without having to redo the effects. Double-click either of the smart objects to open your text layers. Then, double-click any of the smart objects to open the original source text. If your replacement text is going to be longer than your original, you'll need to make more room on the sides. To do this, go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the units of measurement to percent, and in the Width field, I'll type in 150 to ensure there'll be enough room. If you can't see all of your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Double-click the T icon on your text layer to highlight all of your characters and type out your new text. Open your Move tool and close the tab of the replacement text. When you see this message, click Yes to replace your original text with your new text. Then close this tab and click Yes. Next, I'll show you how to quickly change the color. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Drag the hue slider to the right and left. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.